This is a local company, new kid on the block called Luminasa. This gentleman is called Christian Kudoba. Welcome to EcoSummit.
Hi.
And here's your clicker.
Okay. Hi, everyone. It's really exciting to be the last speaker on such a huge and important conference. And I guess I earned it because I, having been the last, reaching out to Jan. So, but nonetheless, we are here, and I'm the last one between before the party, so I don't take too much time. So before, we really start and look into it, let me explain a little bit what we did over the last year. We have been founded last year. We won an award of the ICT Innovation Contest in Germany in August. We are live since February in Berlin Brandenburg with first end users on our platform. And what is most important for us, because our real target customers are utilities, and we already identified and are working with one utility who will implement our platform. So now let me explain where it's all coming from. Right? You have seen it also yesterday in Volker's discussion. Germany, there's 1.4 million power plants now instead of the traditional 200 ones. A little bit less known or in the mind of people is that also the stakeholder structure changing completely. Right? Volker has shown it also, utilities, the traditional utilities are not having a huge portfolio in renewables. Yeah. Instead, these 1.4 million power plants belong to households, farmers, small medium enterprises, cooperatives, all types of people. Right? And you see, it's pretty much equally distributed all over Germany, but at the same time, it's not possible for me as a consumer to buy the electricity from the windmill nearby, which is very strange. Yeah? Even stranger is that nobody is really earning money on that other than the producers who's getting a feed-in tariff. The utilities are not earning money on that because basically there's no product out there. And that's what we are actually trying to change. Yeah? But it's also very important to remember we are not starting from zero. Yeah? In the first quarter 2014, 27% of all electricity in Germany was produced that, in that way, coming from distributed energy sources, mainly renewable energy sources in Germany. So 27% of the energy in Germany not really marketed in a good manner. So that's where we come in. We say, okay, let's have a regional marketplace where we connect all the producers in that region and sell the electricity to people in the same region. It's all, of course, software-based. It's the easy part is connecting them. The complex part is really to do it such a way that you always have the same supply of energy matching the demand on energy. So there is control mechanisms, optimization algorithms. It is highly scalable to really reach to that many people, right? And we do all the forecasting optimization that is needed to run that. By doing so, we get a lot of data on our platform, and we use the data to show it to people, yeah, to provide information how they can better manage the energy in their region, but also on a personal level. So that they get a much more active involvement in what's happening and how the energy transformation is actually happening in their region. This platform we're actually selling as a cloud service to utilities. That's our goal, and we're very happy that we found one who's willing to work with us. Let's have a look how does it look like when we go to connecting, for example, a household that has a solar panel on its roof. Yeah? Of course, we have our cloud platform, but there is also a small, what we call control gateway that we need to install on-site, which connects to the AC converter, controls the panel production. But even more importantly, we reach out to big consumers in these households. It happens to be many of them start to having batteries. They start having thermal storage quite common, or thermal heating systems, or heat pumps that we can control. And as we only focus on such big consumption devices, we are not integrating a fridge or so. The box is pretty cheap and pretty simple. Very simple time shifting commands, so it's not complex and therefore very affordable on the household side. And what works in a small household pretty much also works on the utility level. Yeah? This is pretty much what we are doing for this one utility. So they are traditional utility, they have power, they produced by coal and gas still today. They also provide district heating. And what they do is they, in parallel to the standard product on the coal and gas basis, they introduce a regional premium product based on our platform. They connect producers that are already existing today in the area on the platform, but they're also investing in own renewable energy production. So, and what they also do, they invest in a thermal storage on utility size level, right? So whenever they have excess energy, they put it in the thermal storage and wait for the winter so that they can feed it into the district heating system. So it's a pretty nice, low risk insertion of our platform in a traditional utility environment. So a little bit, what does the user say, or the people working on the platform see? It's of course they see the region, they see what power plants are connected. If they click on these icons, they get pretty detailed information about the power plant type, building year, how much CO2 is saved. And you also see that with a 50-minute time resolution, they see how much energy is produced and consumed in that region, and clearly from that data you can provide tools and give hints how you bring up the utilization rate. And pretty much what we do on the regional level, we do also for each home, especially the homes that are also producing energy. Couple of words to our utilities. The municipal utilities, like the very big ones, you read in the papers all the time, they have a big challenge. The traditional business model of electricity production from coal, gas, nuclear is not working anymore. Everybody knows that. So what's next? And what we provide them is a platform that they can build on their own strength and still be more in a broker role, but still earn money from selling energy. And the market is also very attractive because there are 800 of these utilities in Germany alone. And what they get out, they really focus on their strength, they are anchored in their region, they connect to the producers, they connect to consumers, are able to win new customers. And what is also very interesting to them, if they are able to balance the supply and demand in their network area, they even save money that they otherwise have to pay to the upstream grid operators. So a nice side effect. The end users, is a little bit, the regionality is today like the new bio. So why is that? Because it provides the necessary transparency, you know where to get the energy from, and it reduces complexity because it's much easier to understand, okay, I have the windmill, I have this biogas plant, I have this water power, hydropower supply, and so on, instead of talking in anonymous energy transformation, Germany or even European level wide. On the production side, it's also attractive because they get a little bit more money than before, so rather easy to convince them. The market is potentially huge. It's already huge because there's already 27% of this electricity produced that way. And if you make a calculation that you extract about 1 cent per kilowatt handled by such a platform, you come to rather big numbers in Germany alone, right? It's already a market of 1 billion today and it's growing. The last slide I actually leave to you because I'm up with my 8 minutes to read and rather take some questions.
We have a question for Christian. Do you already have revenue?
Yes, we have a little bit of revenue since we started in February, right? And we're targeting a little bit more by the end of the year, but we're also definitely looking for funding to help us grow the customer base now.
How much money do you want to raise?
1.3 million.
1.3?
Yeah.
Okay. We got it. All right. Thank you very much, Christian.